What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. In this one, I wanted to show three clips from the most recent coaching session I did for a Grand Champ 1 player, followed by some gameplay where I put those tips into practice myself. I think there's a lot to learn here, so enjoy. I also want to mention that these clips come from the free coaching sessions that I run. They're anywhere between an hour to 2 hours long, and I stream the whole things on Twitch. And if you're interested in how to get the free coaching for yourself, stay tuned to the end and I'll give you some more info. I mean, this is really complicated in threes. I would even go as far as to say, since you're not being challenged right away, wait a little bit longer before you touch this. Because what you've done is you've just given the ball away here and given this guy a free opportunity to challenge you. So look, watch when he goes at the ball. It's right when you tap it away from yourself. You tap it and he jumps. If you don't tap this ball, it gives you so much of a better option, because what you can do is you can see where he's coming from. And if it looks like he's gonna challenge, look for him and play it around him. If it looks like he's going to play back, if he's not comfortable jumping yet and he's gonna hesitate, keep the ball close. The longer you wait, the more you'll be able to see your teammates. Like this guy, we'll call him Reese, I think that's how you pronounce it. You'd be able to pass it to him, no problem, right? I can already see you have the mechanical skill to do that. So just pay attention when you're on defense and the other team's giving you space. Do what you can to not hit it away from yourself, right? Threes, you should almost always, unless you guys mess up really bad, you should almost always have someone who's ready to challenge. When you talk about messing the opponents up, who's gonna have an easier time messing them up? Is it you from this position, or is it this guy?
Yeah.
Right? This guy has a great touch, but you're kind of in his way, and then you turn on it and look at where all of you are, right? When you leave and go take the third man spot, it's going to let your teammate who's coming from here know that it's their turn to go, and they can pick up speed, try to challenge better. I'm interested to see his POV as well, right?
Yeah, I am curious about that as well, because when I play with higher ranked teammates, like not only solo queue, my friend, they know enough to not go for it and let me take the play, and they can play the middle.
And that's something that like is totally possible. I look at that as a mix up, right? Rather than standard rotation. If you can interrupt and you get a really good play there, then sure, having a teammate who's ready for that is awesome. You have to have good chemistry with your teammate. Because if I stop here and I go to this POV, right? And I say like, look at orange team, who's the one who's out of position?
Right? Yeah, me.
Yeah, so when you solo queue, it's really important that once you took your shot and you're starting to go this way, once you can rotate off, take the third man, solo queue, it's so important to open up the space. Once you're first man, you should automatically be thinking, I'm ready to become third man. Okay, look at this again.
I should have asked my teammate.
That,
or maybe keep it close.
Both are better options than just bop, here you go, blue team. Remember that like if you're about to touch the ball, there's gotta be an intention behind it. Am I shooting? Am I controlling? Yeah. Or am I passing? Those are the only three options. Yeah. I agree that sometimes you just want to put up a shot to waste the opponent's boost and to make them awkward. This is not one of those moments. They're fully set. They're planted. They're ready to defend. So either pass or dribble. I go for dribble, right? That's my go-to, because from a dribble, you have all those options, right? It's so much harder for them to cover because they don't know what you're gonna do with it.
I felt like dribbling was a little bit slow. Maybe air dribble is a better option.
Well, that's why I said smooth dribbles and catches are so, so important. So like a skill I'm gonna ask you to learn is how quickly can you catch a ball in a smooth dribble. That's a very hard thing to do, and it's so effective. When that happens, right, instead of hitting it away, you'll be dribbling it towards their net with this passing option, with the shooting option, and if this guy just dives in at you while you're dribbling, pop it over his head. I did make a training pack for this that I will link to you. Catch into flick. There's a variety of shots in this. Some, the focus is just the catch. The others, the focus is the flicks. But how quickly can you get this into a smooth dribble and then a flick, right? Next shot. This one, easy, easy catch. So how quickly can you get this to be a smooth dribble, right? So I'm queued up for a game here, and I'm doing something I basically never do, which is queue ranked. I've just kind of retired from ranked, but I think right now I'm around GC 1 and 3s, so the skill level will be pretty comparable to what you saw in the replay, and I'm just going to try to take my own advice, right? Smooth dribbles, keep possession, try to always get that 1-2-3 rotation, one on, one behind, one across. And yeah, solo queue, 1475, there we go. So this is GC1, just beneath 1500. I want to say it should be an easy win, but we'll see. Gotta have our teammates clicking on all cylinders. So let's see what we got. Leave that off for my teammate who went to the back there. Cover net. A little dangerous, but again, if it's going off backboard, you can pretty much assume they're gonna double tap. And now that we're really into the flow of it, we're gonna try to just keep that focus on covering the open space, one on ball, one behind ball, one across from ball. That's really how you rotate in threes and what makes it easier. Unfortunately, they're a bit close there. This guy still wants it, so I'm gonna just keep covering the open space until I get that opening to go. We get it right there. Get a touch on it, not enough boost. So we're spacing the field. We're playing pretty reserved right now, but it's exactly why the spacing works so well. Try to get a bump in as well. And the double commit. There you go. Apparently that's the strat in GC1 3D3s. Oh my goodness. It works out. It works out. See, that's the thing too. If you're going to go into threes and solo queue, make sure that your teammates are the ones who are double committing and that you're never involved in the double commit. I can hear my teammate up as well, but I think I made it clear enough that I was going to go. Nearly had it. Play across. I'm just going to have to pass this back. Oh, unlucky there. Low boost in the right position. Probably a mistake out of me. I'm first back, so I should have this. And there I hit it away. One, because boost is low, and two, because the guy's right up in my face. If he gave me more space there, that's where I go for the dribble. Here, just like in the replay that I was reviewing, rotate off when you think your teammate has a better angle. You get a save out of it and an attack. So I'm still on. Just gonna try to apply pressure. Once I'm done, rotate off. Checking for my teammate at all times, right? Because I never wanna cut rotation. I wanna make sure that whoever's third man gets to become second man. That can be really frustrating in solo Q3s when you're third man and you're ready to go next, but someone just drives in front of you, basically full 2v2 rotation. So again, just always, once your contribution is done, go cover the open space, play third man. Bit low boost here, so I think I have time to grab this because he's going up. Nice save from my teammate. Good job on us to not double commit. And now while we have the attack, I want to be there just in case, but teammate plays it well. Let's give him a nice one. Let him know that we love him. Throw an on your right in the chat as well. Try to get this kickoff to me. It works. I guess we'll go for double. Unless we get bumped off. But look at that. Good job on my teammates. And then, since we're already up 2-0, we'll cover the open space. I saw my teammate coming back down the near post sideline, so I just left it for him. Looked like he was going to go there, didn't it? Just float that. I think that's relatively safe. Cover far post here. Now, while they're both on it, just try to keep some momentum in net. Play backboard here. Nice, managed to hit it around him. That's coming straight to me. Tried to keep it close enough. I didn't get quite the touch I wanted. It got away from me a little bit. Teammate should have. So I'll just cover behind him. Now I'm second man, which means... ah, he's still up. Out of the corner of my eye, I see that guy still flying at the ball. So again, the last thing you want to do in threes is double commit. There, the guy's still close, and I'm sure my teammates need some time to recover. That's why I hit it away. Very intentional. I don't think he has double here. I think good call out of my teammate to go as well. Once you get a lead like this as well, it's perfectly okay to just play reserved, right? Let them make mistakes, hit the ball away from themselves. Cover backboard. Almost got the pinch there with my teammate. That would have been pretty cool. And low boost, so I have to make sure I get back as fast as possible. Cover the far post spot. It's unfortunate that the corner didn't spawn. But here we go. Ball's probably going to come right to me. Good save out of them. And then just recover. Again, we have one on, one behind, one across. There's not much blue team can do when we're positioning well like this. So I'm just going to come in, cut that. Let my teammate go, make sure I don't double commit. Wrap away and leave mid boost in case my teammate wants it. And I'll take that spot behind my teammate. All right, let's get a flip reset here. Nearly had it. Nice of them to leave me boost. I was just trying to rotate. I didn't even want to hit that, but this works. Just cover net. It's going to roll right down to me. That should be fine. And I pass it to them. Oh, my teammates are goats. Love these teammates. Now I'll just stay here. My teammate's in the corner, so I'm just going to come back to net, try to keep some momentum, make sure they don't get a free shot off. Ah, oh well. 3 seconds left, they can't win it. That's a W. Hope it seemed clear. I think the one thing that I wish I did better was a few moments where I would keep more control, but that is life in 3v3s. It's just the way she goes. So, hope you guys were able to learn something. Obviously, it wasn't free of mistakes, but I think it was definitely a good baseline for how to rotate in threes and play with your teammates. I do wish at some points I had kept better control of the ball, but we still got the W. I also promised I would talk a bit about my free coaching. The way it works is you just hit the Discord link that is in the description of this video, and that'll have you join my server. And then from there, I post coaching times in this channel right here, where you can react to it to sign up, and my server bot will pick a random winner who gets the session for free. And that's pretty much all you gotta do. So I appreciate you guys for watching. Have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you in the next one.